Thank you very much. Let me briefly introduce myself and we will begin. First, I have a request. Everybody in the back, all of you people in the back, move up a little bit. Move up. All you people in the back, move up a little bit. People sitting back toward the back. Yeah, very nice. Yeah, there's no use having people way back there. I'll briefly introduce myself and we will begin. My name is Marshall. I'm from a small town called Valley Station, Kentucky. I went to school in Indiana. I got a PhD at UCLA. I was a college professor and dean when I was very young. Then for the past 40 years, I've done four things. I give talks or teach classes like today, which is what I love to do the most. I travel all around the world. I've been to 100 countries, and I have 11 million frequent flyer miles just on one airline, American Airlines. Then I coach executives, which I'm most famous for. I've been the coach of the CEO of Ford and Pfizer and Glaxo and the World Bank and many, many wonderful people. And I had a good day yesterday. Yesterday, for the third year in a row, I got ranked number one coach in the world. So it was a good day. And in terms of my coaching, I haven't announced this, but I'm retiring. I have a theory. Go out on the top. So I've been number one. They've ranked people 3 years. I've been number one every year. So, you know what? Let's move on. I'm going to do the other thing I'm going to keep doing, though, is speaking and writing. I also write. I've done 36 books. Book number 37 is coming out very soon. It'll be out in April. And it's called How Women Rise. And it's written with my great friend, Sally Helgeson. I'm just going to give you, we have a short period of time, a couple of the highlights from the book today that I hope are very helpful to you. I'm very excited about the book, so I think it's possibly a very popular book. So I've done 3 New York Times bestsellers, and hopefully this will be number 4. So I'm very, very excited about the book, How Women Rise. And then I do articles and videos. Now, I give away all my material. So if you go to my website, www, just my name, marshallgoldsmith.com, I give everything away. All of my material you may copy, share, download, duplicate, use any way you wish. I have 200 videos online. I've got hundreds of articles online. I'm giving everything away. The other thing I do is I'm adopting people. So I'm adopting 100 people. I'm teaching them everything I know for free. And the only price is when they get old, they get to do the same thing. And I have an amazing group of people that have signed up for this. Hello! An amazing group of people who signed up for the program. So it's very, very exciting. It's a nice kind of legacy project to do when you get a little older. So it's been great fun. Now, what are we going to talk about today? We have a short period of time. The first thing we're going to do today is each one of you is going to get to meet somebody new. So I want you to stand up. I want you to look around the room. Find one person you don't know and sit next to that person. Go! Stand up. Stand up. Go find a partner you don't know. Perfect. You can talk to each other then. Sit by your partner. Sit by your partner. Sit, sit, sit. Sit by your partner. Sit. Now, sit, sit, sit. Let's go. Sit. Sit by your partner. Sit, sit, sit. Shh, shh, shh. Quiet. Shh. Quiet, quiet, quiet. Sit, sit, sit. Sit by your partner. Now, we're going to practice peer coaching. In peer coaching, you're not here to judge. You're not here to critique your partner. You're here to help your partner. I want you to shake hands with your partner and say, partner, my name is, I'm here to help. Shake hands. My name is, I'm here to help. All right, now let us begin. In my new book for women, we talk about Sally Helgeson is my friend. She's written many books for women. She's that lead author on the book, so I'm the second author. We have come up with several things that women tend to have problems with much more than men. First, the average woman in 360-degree feedback, the average woman in 360-degree feedback gets better feedback than the average man. The average woman is perceived to be a better leader than the average man. Now, this doesn't mean that every woman is better than every man. It just means statistically, the average woman is seen as a better leader than the average man. By the way, this is not a theory. It's a very well-documented statistical fact. For the women in the room, the average woman has one issue to deal with consistently and amazingly more than the average man. And as I look into your eyes, I sense the problem with many of you in this room right now. What is this? Put cell phones away, cell phone, cell phone. What is this one issue? The desire to be the perfect everything to everyone. women are harder on themselves than men. One coaching I have with women far more than men is this: please quit being so hard on yourself. Please do not be so hard on yourself. You cannot be the perfect wife, mother, friend, boss, the perfect everything. Another issue women have that is related is perfectionism, trying to be that perfect everything to everyone. How many of you are from India? Raise your hand. Women from India. Women from India, you get a bonus problem. Are you ready for the bonus problem? Not only do you have to be the perfect mother, the perfect wife, the perfect professional, the perfect boss, the perfect everything, you get to be the perfect daughter-in-law as well. Oh, yeah, the perfect daughter-in-law from India. And let's face it, women, you weren't really good enough for her little prince, were you? No, no, not really, no. And by the way, you don't really cook as well as mom. No, no, of course not, no. So you get that bonus guilt. Now, this is one difference between India and America. In America, that's not a problem. It's seldom a problem. In fact, what did my mother, do you know what my mother told my wife when I got married? My mother talks to my wife. She finds out we're going to get married. And you know what she told my wife? She goes, her name is Lida. She said, Lida, I failed. Now it's your turn. And she said, if this marriage doesn't work out, I won't blame you. So the expectations were not so high. My wife didn't have a big bar to jump over. She didn't have a classic Indian mother-in-law to deal with. Now,